This is Dr. Anuradha Kishore, who is currently working as a pediatrician. So, doctor, what was your main motivation to pursue this career and how did you prepare yourself?
Good morning, Johan. It's really nice to talk to you about your project, which is about career choices. So, if I talk about the choice I made for my career, I chose to become a doctor and then further specialize as a pediatrician, where I work with children. So I think as a young student like yourself, when I was entering my high school, I was very, very keen in the sciences. And I showed a lot of curiosity about the human body and the functions of a human body systems. And I would go around asking questions to whoever was ready to answer them for me. And my teachers picked up on that and they guided me and they took me towards the idea of doing medical profession as my career. So by taking further guidance from my teachers and from my parents, I found out that I could take my entrance exams and join a medical school. So I was lucky to get into the AIIMS All India Institute in Delhi and do my undergraduation. And while doing that, I was so interested in dealing with children and seeing how I could help them in their times of need and distress that I decided to do my specialization in pediatrics. And for that, I went to England and I did my MRCP in pediatrics. And I've come back to India to work with the children of our country and help them as much as I can.
That sounds great. So it's lovely that you are helping children and you love working with kids. So what guidance do you have for students who are interested in taking up pediatrics as a profession?
Okay, sure, Johan. So I would say that it is always good to do a planning in the reverse manner so that first you set your goal and that you work on getting all the means ready to reach your end. So if you have decided or somebody is deciding to get into medicine as a profession, the first and foremost thing would be to check out if that is the kind of life, the work which entails that kind of life. And for finding that out, you should find out a person who's in active practice, in a hospital-based practice, in a busy practice, and then with request to that person, become an observer and try and get a situation where you can shadow observe that person for a few days and see a regular day at work and see what the day entails, what kind of hard work goes into it, what kind of thought processes are involved, what kind of emergencies the person deals with, and then come back and check in your own self whether you want to do that. And if you're totally passionate to go ahead and choose the field of medicine, then the next step would be to choose the three sciences. And that should begin from senior school itself, from grade 9. You should have all three sciences, biology, chemistry, and physics. And when you're reading these sciences, it is not just to take a school test or a school exam. Your knowledge should be as in-depth as possible. You should keep clearing your concepts time to time. Don't let them pile up thinking I'll clear them later, because each concept build on another concept. So keep clearing your concepts in time. Take help from your teachers. Take help from other people who are good at the subject and build a strong base of knowledge. And once you're ready with your knowledge base in depth, you will surely crack your entrance exams and do very well. And don't take stress. These are not difficult exams. Just with good reading, regular coaching, and regular clearing of your concepts, you can surely crack these exams. And all the best to those who are thinking.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you so much for your time and thank you for your insights. I hope to see you soon.
Yes, Johan. Good luck to you too. Bye-bye. Have a good day. Bye.